Madam, on behalf of our party, we oppose the Pension Fund Regulation and Development Authority Bill. Madam, since before independence, the main attraction of a government job, either in the central or the state government, was that it ensured a pension which a person would get till the end of life. And in central government, the spouse would also get half the pension money till the end of his or her life. Now, this government, in 2004, they started a new pension system. What was the new pension system? The new pension system said that people could invest in a pension fund and there could be several pension funds in the country, of which one would be a government company. The bill, this bill, has been pending since 2005. It was sent to the standing committee, sent back. The government again brought amendments to the bill in 2009, but so far the bill was not passed. I want to ask of the finance minister, it is all right, you open a pension fund for the people who are not central or state government employees. Let those in the unorganized sector, those who are working in private companies, invest or contribute in a pension fund. Then you do what you want to do with it. You play the market. But as far as government employees are concerned, their security should be ensured and government should only invest in government securities. Maybe the return will be less, but let them at least be given a social security for the future. Now, what has the minister done? He has gone ahead and yes, he is setting up a Pension Fund Regulation and Development Authority. It will have a chairman, it will have members, it will have powers to impose service charges, it will have power to impose penalties, and it will also have the option of investing in the stock market, in the share market. Now, basically, if you play the share market with people's social security money, it is subject to market risk. You know, when somebody invests in a mutual fund, it is always written, the mutual fund is subject to market risk. So you are subjecting the social security component to the market. This is an idea to bring more money, the savings of people, into the market so that the share market can move. I know that the option is there if somebody wants. It's an individual-based pension fund. So if a subscriber wants, he can decide that I shall only invest in government securities. That freedom is given to him. But what the pension funds will do, they will lure people with greater returns and let them invest in pension funds where the return will be high. And if the market crashes like it does in America, what happens to the future of these people? Now, after having set up a pension fund, the minister has set up an elaborate structure. I have nothing to say. If the government insists, they will need this elaborate structure. They have also set up advisory committees on the pension funds. They have also allowed a person in point, even bank branches, who will be able to collect deposits in the pension fund. But I said earlier that this pension fund idea takes away the concept of assured future for government employees, which we are opposed to. Again, in an amendment, the finance minister is allowing 26% FDI into the pension fund. Madam, it is not clear to me that what great skill is required in investing money in the pension fund. Why you want foreign companies to come into our pension fund areas, and what benefit? On the one hand, the bill says that you cannot invest pension fund abroad. On the other hand, you say that you are unconfused. You can have FDI. We oppose FDI up to 26% in pension fund. We ask the finance minister to have a pension fund for non-government employees. But please assure the future of central and state government employees instead of creating a huge mechanism to promote your pension fund and bring more savings into the market. Madam, one point only.